Good morning, guys. John Kerry, 1963 Jag, back with you here on Sunday, January 15th, I think, and it's about 10 o'clock in the morning. A little cold here in Northern California, not too bad, nothing like what you guys in Canada are suffering from, but just decided I'd get out in the garage, do a few things, and I wanted to show you what I was doing. I mentioned this a little while ago, the suspension parts for my car had been powder coated, and have a look at that. The powder coat is just cracking, splitting, peeling in all different corners and parts of the suspension components, and it really is frustrating me. So I decided to take a heat gun and kind of warm it up a little bit and try and scrape it off, and what I found was that doesn't work too well. The warm, it got hot, but it really wasn't releasing the bad powder coat. So what I did is I just took a cold, left it cold, and I've taken an old wood chisel and started chipping it off. So I'm going to give you guys a little view of what I'm doing here. So just one of my old cheapy Ace Hardware wood chisels that I've had laying around forever. I've got in this wooden box here like three different sets of wood chisels that I can use for different things, but none of them are really very sharp. I'm not a woodworker anymore. I used to be, but a long time ago I had a couple of good sets, but now they're just utility tools. So just kind of working my way along the edge like this. You see how a little hard to hold the camera and do this at the same time, so I'm just going to put you down for a second and pick this up right where I'm leaving off. Well, so there's a snapshot. Look at some of the pieces that are coming off of this on the floor. I mean, that is just a great big gob of powder coating that just gave up. Just didn't adhere at all. Look at the tabletop here. Look at some of this stuff. Just falling off, right? Like I said. So I've been working with a chisel. You can see there, just sort of keeping it low. The angle of attack is pretty critical to get it down under the coating. If I hit it just right, I can take a complete strip off. You can see some of the marks from where I was working. I'm not too impressed with powder coating as a restoration technique. Take a look at this. I mean, there is some serious rust that was buried right under that powder coat. This was completely coated, looking like it was in perfect shape. And look at the rust that's starting to build down in that corner. Can you see it? There's a little more light. This is not impressive to me, and I'm not inclined to be a big fan of powder coating based on that. That's really terrible. That's a lot of rust right there. So, there's other rust spots right there. There's another one. Quite a bit of surface rust over here, but that's where the powder coating had failed. You can actually see the stain from where it was exposed. And but that other spot on the big bolt, that was completely covered. Here's another one. That's surface rust, but maybe that light's too bright. Let me bring it over here under the fluorescence. Maybe you can get a better view. That surface rust right there was completely covered by the what looked like good powder coat, but the minute I started scraping on it, it just started coming off in sheets. So, not so impressed. I don't know, maybe people who know powder coating can tell me what was the problem, if it was a poor preparation or other techniques. Maybe this is a very flat, very smooth piece of steel. Maybe that's part of the problem. It's got to be rougher. Maybe castings take it a lot better, but this is terrible. I mean, look at the mess on my benchtop just from scraping on it, and it's flying everywhere. It's all over the place. All right, so I'll give you another look at this when I'm all done. Okay, here's the finished product. So what I did is I finished scraping it off with a chisel, and then I put it in my blast cabinet and took some of the residue, some of the rust, some of the crud off it. And it got it pretty clean, but I wasn't real happy with it. It wasn't perfect. So what I did is I took out my little die grinder and a little, 40 grit or something like that, I think it was, a little disc, and just went over it with a disc and gave it a really good cleaning. And then took some 80 grit sandpaper in my hand and just took the rest of the grit off of it. You can see I got the rust out of these gaps here. Let me get some light on the subject. Yeah, down in that gap there, that was all rusty, so that's nice and clean. Down in there, nice and clean. Same thing on the other end. Got the rust out of there and out of there. Whoops, well, maybe I didn't get it all. Maybe I see a little bit down in there, so I have to do a little more. What I'm going to do is etch this with some metal prep, and then I'll put the etch primer and the black enamel on it like I did with the suspension parts. And so it'll match, so should be good. So there you go, one failed powder-coated suspension brace that is now completely...